Okay, so let us start now. So we're saying that if sine theta equals negative 5 over 13, and the theta lies between what? Between 90 and 217. Calculate without this calculator, with the aid of a diagram, the value of the form, that is sine 2 theta and the cos 2 theta. I think you see them here. Ne? Now, if you look at what we have, they gave us the sine theta, right? They gave us what? Sine theta. And they said that our sine theta equals to what? Sine theta equals to negative what? Negative 5, okay, over 13, okay. Are we together? Now, if you see our given sine theta, is it positive or negative?
Our what?
The sine theta given to us, is it positive or negative?
It's positive.
Oh, what is a negative on 5? So it is negative. I get it. You see the negative on 5, ne? It means a given sine theta is what? Is negative. Are we together? So now, they gave us the quadrants, ne? They said the theta must lie between what? Must lie between 90 and what? 90 and 270, right? Meaning that we are going to,
yes,
we are going to check where sine theta is supposed to be negative, okay? Okay, so if I'm going to draw the, if I draw our quadrants, okay, like this, like this one here, okay, and then like this, okay. So where is our theta negative? It must begin from, they say begin from 90, eh? So here, this is 90 here, okay, and this is 180, okay, and then this is 270, right? Hope you see what I'm writing, guys, eh? Okay, so now, where is our theta negative, our sine theta negative? Where is our sine negative? Is it going to be A or B? Because I'm indicating the quadrants here. Is it A or B? It is what?
It's B.
It is in B, ne? Which means I'm going to draw my angle in quadrant B, which is the third quadrant, ne? All together. So I'm going to come here and draw my what? My reference angle like this, okay? So my theta gets all the way from zero up to this point here, which I have drawn here, okay? So I'm going to draw my perpendicular now, okay, like this, to come, which must be on the x-axis. Which must be on the what? On the x-axis, this 90 degrees here. This is my theta, okay? So what we said last time, using the Cartesian plane, sine theta equals to what? Anybody who remembers how to find sine? Sine equals to what? Using x, y, and r. Sine equals to what? What do we say?
This one.
Y over r, ne? Yes, y over r, the radius, ne? So in this case, because they gave us negative 5 over 13, I want you to know that the radius can never be negative, ne? So it's this 5 which is on the y, ne? So I'm going to put the 5 here, which is negative, okay? And then my r is positive 13, ne? Are we together? So as you can see, I don't have the x, ne? But I can find, if I use Pythagoras theorem, ne? So I'm going to say x squared, okay? X squared plus what? Plus y squared plus y squared equals to r squared, okay? All right, so I have my y, ne? I have my y. Now, don't forget to put brackets, ne? Our y is negative what? Negative 5, ne? We're going to say negative 5 bracket squared, okay? Equals to, what about our r? It is what? The r is 13, ne? All together? Yeah, so 13 squared, okay? So now, if I get a calculator, what is negative 5 squared? Anybody with a calculator? What is negative 5 squared?
It's positive 25.
Meaning that now I'm going to have x squared, okay? X squared plus 25, ne? All together? Plus 25 equals to, what about 13 squared? It is 169. 169, okay. Now, because the 25 is positive here, it's going to become negative, ne? When it crosses over. And so I'm going to say x squared equals to 169 minus what? Minus 25. Okay, so what do we get? What do we get?
144.
Yes, 144. So meaning now we have x squared equals to 144. So what do I do here, Mshatama? What must I do here to get my x?
You square both sides.
But what did the square? What must I do to know the square?
Introduce a square root both sides.
That's correct. So put a square root, okay. And also here, I'm going to put a square root on 144. So what's square root of 144?
It's x is equal to plus minus 12.
Yes, plus or minus 12. Okay, so now in this case, we have two x values. Ne? We have x equals to positive 12, okay, and x equals to negative 12. Ne? But we must choose which one we are going to use. So what do you think we're going to take here? Is it negative or positive 12?
Negative.
We're going to take a negative. Ne? That is correct. So we're taking negative, so we're going to put negative here, meaning our x is negative 12. Ne? X is negative what? Negative 12. So I'm going to say here, my x is negative 12. Are we together, guys?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so what must we calculate? Calculate what? What must we calculate? Check the question again.
It says we must calculate sine 2 theta.
Yes, sine 2 theta. That's our part A. So part A, we need sine 2 theta. We need sine 2 theta. Now to get our sine 2 theta, because we have only theta, we must expand sine 2 theta. What do we get when you expand it? It gives us what?
It gives us sine 2 theta is 2 sine theta cos theta.
Yes, 2 sine theta cos theta, ne? 2 sine theta cos theta. So from our diagram, we can get our sine theta and the cos theta, ne? So from our diagram, what is our sine theta here from our diagram? What's our sine theta from the diagram? It's going to be what?
Negative
5
over.
Negative what? Negative 5 over 13, ne? All together. What about our cos theta? Kedibone, what's our cos theta from here?
12 over 13.
But negative, ne? Negative what? Negative 12, okay. Over what? Over 13, okay. So now we can get our final answer here. So what is 2 times negative 5 times negative 12? What do we get?
Negative 10 over 13.
Negative 120. I mean positive 120. Because there is a 2 here, ne? This is 10, negative positive 120. Altogether, over what? Over 13. Mshatama, are we together? Times 13, yes. Okay, so it's going to give us actually 120 over what? Over 169, okay? Over 169, okay? 169 here. That's our final answer, ne? That's our sine 2 theta. Hello? Yes, please. How do I get what?
120.
Oh. Because I have, you see there is a 2 here, ne? This is 2 times negative 5, that's negative 10. Then negative 10 times negative 12, it gives me positive 120. Okay. Are we together? No. Okay, so are we together, guys? What is our
Yes.
next question? Part B says what? We must find what? It says we must find cos 2 theta, right? That's part B, right? Must find what? Cos 2 theta, right? So that's part B here. We need to find cos 2 theta. So to get our cos 2 theta, any suggestions? What must we do, guys? We said cos 2 theta can be written in three ways. Ne? Anybody who remembers any of the three ways for expanding cos 2 theta? The same as what? I'm telling you one way. What is cos 2 theta equals to?
It is equals to cos squared theta minus sine squared theta, or
Yes.
maybe
Cos
theta
squared
theta.
theta, okay. Minus what? Minus sine squared
Sine squared.
theta, right? Are we together? Sine squared theta. Okay. So now that we have the cos and the sine, we can substitute, right? And what is our
Yes.
cos of theta again from the diagram? What's our cos of theta?
Negative.
Negative what?
Negative 12/13.
Yes, but don't forget to square, right? Because in our expansion there is a square, right? So you're gonna say squared
Yes.
here. What about our sine of theta? You said is what?
Negative 15/15. I mean negative 5/13 squared.
Yes, negative 5 over 13 squared. Okay, so here now we are going to expansion here again. So what is negative 12 over 13 squared? What do you get? Edivoni, what do you get? What do you get? You get
144/159.
over. What about here? This one, next one here, we get what?
No, this is for the
So maybe positive 25, right?
well, what is negative 25/5/169?
Yes, okay. 169. So now if you subtract 144 minus 25, what do you get? Come again?
119/169.
119 over 165, ne? 169, sorry, ne? 169. So can it simplify any further, or it stops here?
I think we stop here. Let's stop here.
Okay, no problem. That's our answer then, ne? Okay, so anybody with a question, please ask. If you have a question, ask. Otherwise, we are continuing to the next question. Any question? Kedibone, are we together?
Yes, sir.
Did you get it right?
No.
But you get it now, ne? Okay. Are you guys done writing? Because I have to go to the next question.
Sir, can I please ask, ma'am,
Yes,
more
ask.
especially when drawing this thing, because once you get the drawing wrong, you automatically get almost everything right wrong. So,
Yes.
sir, when I want to draw my diagram, what should I actually look at besides the restriction?
Why do you stay
Oh,
beside the restrictions? You must be
I want to
restricted.
like, for
Let us
example,
let
ma'am,
me, let me explain again one more time, ne? You see, the given sine theta is negative, right? So
Oh.
meaning that we first locate that quadrant where sine is negative, ne? Like in this case, we can say sine is negative. We see it's negative here. It's negative in this quadrant, right? All together.
Yes, sir.
Also negative in this quadrant here. We are putting x, ne? All together.
Okay.
But then now look at the given quadrants, ne? They said we must choose from what? From 90 to 270, which means this 90 begins from here, okay? And then this is 180, as you can see here, 180. And this is 270, which means We can choose either from this quadrant, okay, or from this quadrant here. All together.
Yes, sir.
So where the two conditions are met, that's where we choose. Yes.
Okay, I wanted, you know, besides, I wanted to know where my sine or cos or tan being negative, like it's the one which guides me. Okay, now I get it.
Yeah, that's what guides you, ne?
Okay.
In other words, we don't guess, ne? Please never guess, okay? Okay, so can I kill off this or you're still writing somebody?
I can clean up.
Okay, no problem. Thank you. Let me clean off this. Let me clean off this one here. Okay. Okay, next question now. Next question. Let us check it out. What does it say? What does it say? Let's check it out.
It says if 3 cos theta is equals to root 5 and theta is restricted for at one from 180 to 360, then calculate the use of a calculator and with a diagram the value of a sine 2 theta.
Yeah, you can stop there now. So again, we can see the restrictions, ne? They gave us, they said 3 cos theta is root 5, and then our theta lies between what? 180 and less than 360, ne? So let us first write down what we have. So we have got two restrictions, ne? First of all, our cos theta, okay, they said that 3, we are doing part, okay, they said 3, okay, cos of theta equals to what? Equals to root 5, ne? Are we together? Root 5 here. So we divide by 3, ne? Which gives us cos of theta. Cos of theta equals what? Root 5 over what? Over 3, ne? Root 5 over 3, okay. So now, as you can see from here, this one is positive, ne? You see it is positive, right? So we don't have a negative. So then look at the other restriction now. They said that our theta lies between what? Lies between 180. But not and then up to 30, up to 360, ne? So from 180 up to what? Up to 360. So we are going to draw now the Cartesian plane, ne? If I draw it here like this, okay. If I draw it here like this, and then this side here again like this, okay. Now we follow the first condition, ne? It said the cos was positive, ne? Where do we have cos positive cos here? Which quadrants is cos positive?
And in the fourth quadrant.
Yeah, cos is positive in the first, okay? And even the what? And the fourth quadrant, ne? All together. Now look at our given restriction. They said we see our cos is positive, ne? So where else is cos positive? Where is cos positive? Where is cos positive?
Fourth quadrant.
Yeah, now cos is positive in the fourth quadrant, okay? And also in the first, ne? All together. But they say that we must choose from 180 up to 360. So this is 0. Check, this is 0. This is 90, okay? And then this is 180, okay? And then this is 2 what? This is 270. And then this is 360, okay? So which we must choose beyond what? We must choose beyond 180, which means we can choose either from here, okay? Or from here, all together. So where are we gonna choose? Are we gonna take A or B? What do you think?
I think we are going to take what do you call this B?
You're going to
I
take
stand to
B.
Be correct. I think we're going to take because our x is positive from the statement given.
And what else? Because we must choose above 180. You see, this is 180 and above, so we cannot choose a altogether. So
yes,
we are going to draw our reference angle in the fourth quadrant. Are we together, Kedimoni?
Yes, sir, we're together.
Thank you. So now I'm going to draw the reference angle here. It like it is, then now I'm going to draw my 90 degrees again, like it is. It must be on the x-axis, don't forget. Now, our theta we're talking about, it gets all the way from zero, like this, up here, okay? So, this is our angle we're talking about here, okay? So, meaning that in this case, our theta here, how do we find, how do you find, because they gave us cos, how do you find the cos? Cos equals to what? In the terms of the Cartesian, what did we say? Cos equals to?
X over R.
Ne? So, what's our x here? It is root 5, ne? So, we're going to put root 5 here on the its x-axis, ne? I'm going to put root 5 here, okay? And then I'm gonna put the 3, okay, as the hypotenuse, ne? So I don't know my y here, but I'm going to find it now, ne? By using Pythagoras theorem, ne? I'm gonna say that y squared, okay, plus x squared must give me what? Must give me r squared, okay? So what is my y? What is our y from that? Yes, is what?
Y squared
through. Actually, I'm looking for y. So, what's my x? Yeah, I have a sorry, beg your pardon. What's my x in the given information? My x is root 5, ne? So, I'm going to say root 5, okay? Root 5, but I don't forget to square, ne? Root 5 squared, okay? Then plus y squared, okay? Equals to, what is our r? It is 3, ne? It's going to be 3 squared, okay? So what do you get when you square root 5? Guys, talk to me. What do you get?
We get 5.
We get 5, okay. And then plus y squared. What about if you square 3? What do you get?
We get 9.
9, okay. What's 9 minus 5?
It's 2. Plus minus 2.
Oh, 9 minus 5, you get what?
Four. Four, ask this. Oh, I rushed to the answer. So to say.
But the answer is not also correct what you said. Okay, anyway, we are going to have our y squared equals to what? Equals to 4, ne? All together?
Yeah.
So, our y squared equals to 4. Y squared equals to 4. Because we're saying 9 minus 5, ne? Which gives us 4, okay? Now we can square root, ne? We can do what? Square root, okay? Also here, square root, which gives us y as what? As plus or minus what? Minus 2, ne? So we come back to our diagram to find out, are we going to take the positive y or the negative y, ne? Let's check now. What do you think, guys, here? Mshatama, am I taking the positive or negative y? Here.
We are going to take the negative 1.
The negative 2. Did you not guess? Why are you saying so?
I'm saying so because from our diagram below, it's shown that our x is positive and we already had the hypotenuse, which is 3. Then the only missing side, that side, it was only the opposite side, and therefore we can see that in that diagram it lies below, you see, yeah, below there,
below the x-axis, ne?
Yes,
that is correct. Okay, so now we can find out what must we calculate. You said calculate what? What must we calculate? The value of what? Sine 2 theta, ne? All together. Yeah, so we need to find sine 2 theta. So when we come here again, our sine 2 theta, our sine tooth. That's what we're looking for. So what do you get when you expand that cardioid bone? What is sine 2 theta?
2 sine cos theta.
2 sine theta, okay. And the cos of what? And the cos of theta. So, but what is our sine from the diagram? What sine theta from our diagram?
It's negative 2 over 3.
Negative 2 over 3, okay. What about our cos of theta?
Root 5 over 3.
That is correct, ne? Okay. Root 5 over 3. So, now we're going to multiply here. What is 2 times negative 2?
Negative 4.
This is going to be negative 4 root 5, ne? Negative 4 root 5. What about 3 times 3? What do you
mean?
9. 9, eh? So we have, here we have negative 4 root 5 over 9. Eh? That's our answer then. Mm. That's our answer. We are done. That is it. What else must we calculate? They say calculate what?
The cos 2 theta.
Yeah, cos 2 theta as well. Eh? So cos 2 theta is what we want now. We need cos 2 theta. So our cos 2 theta, when you expand it in terms of sine, who can tell us in terms of sine? It's the same as what? Mm-hmm. In terms of sine, what is cos 2 theta?
It's 1 minus sine squared theta.
1 minus what?
Sine squared theta.
Is she correct, Kedivone? Hello, is she correct?
Yes.
What is cos 2 theta in terms of sine? You forgot, it is 1 minus 2 sine squared theta, okay? You forgot the 2, ne? 1 minus what? 2 sine squared theta, okay. Are we together now? But from our diagram, what is our sine theta again? What's our sine theta? We say it is negative 2 over what? Over 3, ne? All together? Negative 2 over 3. But then we must square, ne? We must square here. So if you square negative 2 over 3, what do you get? If you square negative 2 over 3, what do you get? You get positive what? Positive 4 over 9, ne? All together. So what is 2 times 4? What is 2 times 4? We get 8 over 9. So what is 1 minus 8 over 9? We get 1 over 9, okay? That's our answer then. For cos of 2 theta alone.
Can I ask if I didn't express my cos theta in terms of sine, but then I still get the answer correct, would I be wrong? Because I expressed it in terms of, I used that one of, what do you say? That one of 2 cos theta, 2 cos squared theta minus 1. I expressed it in terms of cos instead of sine, and I still got the correct, I still got 1 over 9.
Then I'm speechless. That answer is correct. As long as you get the correct answer, ne, then you are right. Okay, if you did not copy from the neighbor, okay? All the methods are allowed. Are we together?
Maybe you did. Tuesday, Wednesday,
Thursday. Okay, let us proceed. Mm-hmm. Next question.
Yeah? See, my list is almost compared to Tuesday Tuesday or Wednesday.
Okay, next here, guys. We need tan 2 theta, ne? Tan 2 theta. So, to get our tan 2 theta, I need your suggestions here. What must we do to get our tan 2 theta? We need to find tan 2 theta. What must we do?
I'm not sure, but then I just expressed We know that tan is given by sine over cos. I just broke that down, but then still introduced my two, like, before sine over cos. So basically, I was like, tan 2 theta is equals to 2 sine theta over cos theta. That's what I did. I'm not sure.
Okay, can you say it again? Huh? Equals to what? 2? Come again. Equals to 2? 2 what?
2.
Uh-huh.
2 sine theta by cos theta.
2 sine theta over cos theta. Ne? Okay. What do you think about Liz Kediboni? Do you think she's correct? Kediboni, talk to us. Do you think she's correct? Okay. Now, Mshatama, you see, you know what you did, ne? Well, now what you did is like this. You did 2 tan theta. This is what you explained. Because there is a 2 here, so it gives you 2 times sine theta over cos of theta. This is what you did, okay? This is what you did. This is what you did. But what you did is not what they're asking for.
Okay, sir.
Okay, now I want you to watch this. You see, if we say tan 2 theta, né? Tan 2 theta is the same as saying sine 2 theta divided by cos 2 theta. I wish you don't forget that. The same as saying what? Sine 2 theta divided by cos what? Cos 2 theta. You maintain the 2. You don't throw it away.
Okay.
How to get an A? But now we know from our previous work, ne? Already we found out sine 2 theta and the cos 2 theta. Ne? So let us check the answers then. What did we get already? This one is for cos 2 theta. The answers are here. I think you can see them. Ne? Here, this one was for sine 2 theta. This one here, sine 2 theta. And then this other one was for cos 2 theta. So I'm going to divide the two answers. I don't know if you're happy with that. Because this is sine 2 theta over cos 2 theta. Guys, are we together?
Yes,
so I'm going to say negative 4 root what? Root 5. Okay. And then over what? Over 9. Then now divide by what? What about cos 2 theta? It's 1 over 9. Eh? Divide by 1 over what? 1 over 9. All together? Now I'm going to change from division to multiplication. Eh? So I multiply by what? By the reciprocal. Eh? Multiply by what? By the reciprocal. So it's going to be negative 4 root 5 over 9 times 9 over 1, right? Times 9 over 1. So I can cancel the 9s, ne? Cancel the 9s here. So I'm going to get negative what? Negative 4 root 5. That's my final answer. Are we together now?
Yes, sir.
Okay. That's why they're asking it at last. Because they know already you have the cos 2 theta and the sine 2 theta already. Are we together now?
Yes, sir.
Okay, write it down. Then we proceed. You tell me when you are done, eh? So we can proceed.
I don't know about doing.
Okay, Dibone, are you done also? You or not yet? Okay, you tell us when you are done. Guys, please, if you don't understand, ask. Ne? Don't fear to ask, please, okay?
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
I'm done.
Okay, now let me clean off the board. Clean off the board now. Okay. All right. We're now cleaning off this stuff. Because you guys are now done and you understand what we're doing now, okay? Okay. Sorry for taking long, but I think it's not so long. almost done here. Okay, so let us proceed. Let us proceed. Next question. Oh, you have to do this one as well. I didn't see it. So I think you see how I choose the quadrant, Mshatamani. You don't guess, ne? Because if you guess the quadrant, you might also guess your marks. Maybe you might guess nothing, you see? You don't have to guess the quadrant. Okay, our next question, question three, it says that if tan what? Read.
It says if tan alpha is equals to, let me zoom in. It says if tan alpha is equals to 12 divided by 5, with alpha being respect to 90 to 270, and cos beta is equals to negative 8 over 70, then with restricted from 0 to 180,
yes.
Calculate the use of a calculator, and with the aid of a diagram, the value of sin alpha plus beta.
Okay, so if we can now draw our quadrants first, ne? We're gonna draw two of them, ne? All together. We're gonna draw two of them.
Okay.
So this first one here, I'm gonna draw it here, like it is. This other one, I'm gonna draw it here as well. Now, if this one is gonna be for tan alpha, né? Now they said that tan alpha equals to what? Tan alpha equals to, they said 12 over 5, right?
Okay.
Over 5, okay. And you see the given tan alpha is positive, né? Altogether. So they say the alpha must be between 90 up to 270, which means we must choose from 90 here, okay? Then 180 and then 270 here, okay? So if I check what I have here, where is tan positive? Tan, where is tan positive?
Positive in the first quadrant and the third quadrant.
Yeah, so 10 is positive here, ne? Altogether, also positive here, ne? And then where is what about the given angle? They said our alpha must choose from what? Must choose from 90 up to 270, ne? So which one do we include? Do we choose this one, A, or do we choose B?
We are going to which one? You're
going to choose which one? Is it A or B?
My Y is closer to A. Where's my X here? My Y and X are both positive. So we're going to choose the B.
B, but B is less than 90, and the same must go above 90. You see, the same must go above 90.
Going to choose the first, I mean A.
We are going to choose A. That's correct, ne? Okay, so our angle from here, like it is, ne? Which means we are going to get all the way from this side up here to give us our weight, to give us our alpha, ne? Okay. But how do you find 10 alpha? Anybody who remembers how do you find 10 in the Cartesian form?
It's y over x.
It's y over x, né? Now in this case, as you can see, because my tan alpha is 12 over 5, what can I do now to get the negatives? I'm gonna do what? I'm gonna say negative 12. Okay, over negative 5, because I know a negative divided by negative gives me positive, ne? Are we together, guys? So I'm gonna find my R, ne? Using Pythagoras, ne? So I'm gonna say my R squared equals to what? X squared plus what? Plus Y squared, okay? Plus Y squared. So what is my X from here? X is what? Negative 5, ne? So negative 5 squared, okay? And then what about our Y? Also negative what? Negative 12, yes, squared. So what's negative 5 squared?
It's equal to positive 25.
What about negative 12 squared? Positive 144. What about when you add them, you get what?
159.
And then now we do what? To get our R. We do what now? We square root, ne? Square root here as well. So what is our R in this case? It is what? 13, ne? We said R will never be negative, ne? Irrespective of the quadrant, ne? So R is 13. So that's to do with the alpha, ne? Let's now talk about the given beta here. They said that our cos beta is negative 8 over 17. Ne? So they said here now, our cos of beta is negative what? Negative 8 over 17. Ne? Okay. So, guys, where is cos negative? Which one is cos negative? Where is
second quadrant.
Come again?
Second quadrant.
The
second quadrant
and the third, ne?
Quadrant.
Okay, that is correct. So, so is that it's positive in this? I mean, positive in the what you said? Negative in the what? In the second and the third, ne? All together. So, and then where is cos? So, if you look at our given information here. They said that we must choose beta from what? From 0 to what? To 180, ne? So this is 0 here, okay? This is 90. And then this is 180. So we don't have to go beyond 180, ne? So it means we have to choose this one here. I don't know if it makes sense to you. Do you get it? Because they said don't go beyond 180. Are we together now? Shatam, are we together?
Yes, sir.
So meaning that in this case, I'm going to draw my reference angle in here. I'm going to say that it's getting from here up to here, you see? So my beta gets all the way from here up to here. That's my beta now, okay? So, but how do we find, if you check what we have our cos beta as negative 8 over 17, ne? So where do I put the negative? Is it on the x or on the radius? I'm gonna say negative 8, right? Here, ne? And because radius must be positive, ne? And then positive 17 here. So I don't know my y, which I'm going to find using Pythagoras, okay? So I'm gonna say x squared plus y squared equals to radius squared. So here, my x is negative 8. I'm going to say negative 8 here, bracket squared, okay? I don't know the y, ne? So plus y squared. What's our radius? It is 17, ne? So 17 squared here. So what is negative 8 squared? Calculators, what do you get? Positive 64, ne? Okay. And what about our 17 squared gives us what? I don't hear you. Come again.
289.
289. 289. Okay. Now I'm looking for the y. So I'm going to say y squared minus equals to what? Equals 289 minus what? Minus 64. What do we get?
225.
225, ne? 225. So what do we do here, Mshataman? Now to get my y, a square root, ne? And what do I get after square rooting? We get 15, ne?
15, yes.
Okay, so from here, am I going to take a positive or negative 15?
We are going to take the negative 15.
Okay, Dibona, is she correct, this girl? Am I taking positive or negative 15?
Yeah.
You take which one?
15.
Positive or negative?
Positive.
Why do,
15, 15.
Why do we say positive? Because it is above what? Above the x-axis, no?
X-axis, yes.
Okay, so now we can answer the question now. Mm-hmm. What must calculate is find the value of sine alpha plus beta, ne? Let's find it. Sine alpha plus beta. Sine alpha plus beta. Don't forget here we have our beta here. It's our beta here. Now we need to find sine, okay, of alpha plus beta. Alpha plus beta. So, what do you get if you expand this? You get what? Mm-hmm. Mshatam, what do you get here? Expand this.
When we expand that one, we are going to say sine. We're going to say sine alpha.
Sine alpha.
We're going to say sine alpha cos beta.
Cos beta, and then.
Then we say plus sine beta plus alpha.
Okay. I hope she's correct, ne? Okay, so now from our diagram, what is our sine alpha? From our diagram, our sine of alpha from blank the diagram. What's our sine alpha? Mm-hmm. It is what?
Can we come from sine alpha?
It is what?
It's going to be sine given by we're going to say it's going to be negative 12 divided by 13.
What about cos beta, Kedimone? What about cos beta?
Mm-hmm.
What about cos beta? It's gonna be negative what? Negative 8, ne? Divided by what?
Yeah.
By 17, okay? All together. And then plus, what about sine beta? Mm-hmm.
Sine beta is going to be it's going to be 15 divided by negative 8. Wait, is it negative 8 or positive 8?
Oh, what?
No.
No, that is for 10. We're talking about sine beta.
Sorry. Yeah.
It's going to be what? Mm-hmm.
15 over 2.
What about cos alpha? What about cos alpha? It's going to be what?
It's going to be 5, negative 5, I mean, it's going to be, it's going to be negative 5 divided by 13.
That is correct, ne? So, if you multiply negative 12 and negative 8, what do you get? Negative 12 and negative 8, what do you get? Multiply for me, you get the answer. Negative 12 times negative 8, what do you get?
Multiply by negative 8, it's going to be 96.
Positive 96, ne? What about 13 times 17, what do you get? 13 times 17?
It's going to be 221.
Okay. What about 15 times negative 5? What do you get?
going to be negative 25.
Yes, okay. Then divide by the same number, né? Which was 2 to 1, okay? 2, 2, 1, okay? As you can see, we have the same denominator, né? So we are going to say 96 minus 75. What is 6 minus 5, guys? You get what? You get 1, né? What about 9 minus 7? Get what? Get 2. Then divide by 2 to 1, okay? Divide by 2 to 1, okay? So, is this our final answer? I hope so. All it can simplify. Can it simplify anymore? Call it stop here. That's our answer then. Write it down, guys, until when you're done, okay? Come again. Are you done?
Yes, sir.
What about Kediboni?
I'm done.
Okay, let us clean off now. Let us clean off now. Okay, next question now. Let's check it out. What does it say here? Question four. It says what? Who can read for us question four? It says what?
It says if 2 sine alpha. Minus, so we are zooming too much. But, if 2 sine alpha is equals to negative 1, with alpha being restricted from 190, I mean from 90 to 270, and tan beta is equal to 2 over root 12, with beta restricted to 90 to 270. Calculate without the use of a calculator and with the aid of a diagram the value of cos alpha minus beta.
So I think you guys can do that now, because now you know what we are doing, right?
Yes,
you can also do number 5, right? I better go to question 6 now, because it's different from what we have been doing, okay? Is it okay?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so read question 6. Hey, by the way, what about question 5, where we say if sine 2a equals to that 1? Do you know how to do it, or must we do it together?
I don't know.
What about do it together, or you think you can do it?
Let's do it together.
Okay, no problem. Okay, so we have sine 2a, okay? Sine 2a equals to what? I said sine 2a equals to root what? Root 5, ne?
5 over 3.
Yes, root 5 over 3. Okay. And then what about the other one? We have what? They said our 2L is between what? 9 and 2, 17. Now, as you can see, the root 5 over 3 is positive, ne? So, where are we going to choose?
Where second quadrant. Choose?
Shatama, do you agree with him?
Are you saying what?
Are we going to do the second quadrant or what? Where is sign positive? They said beyond 90, eh? Because they said from 90 to 70. Eh? So are we going to choose the second quadrant?
Yes, sir.
Can you tell us why? Why do you think so?
Because sign is positive in the second quadrant.
That is correct. Okay. And then also they gave us the what? The restrictions. Eh? They said must go beyond 90. Eh? Altogether? That's why we're going to choose the second quadrant here. Okay, so now we're going to draw our triangle like this, okay? So now when we show the angle here, ne, it's going to be 2A. It will not be only 1A. That's what was confusing you. It's going to be what? 2A. Are we together? So how do you find sine? It is the opposite of hypotenuse, ne? So it's going to be root what? Root 5, okay. Root 5 here divided by 3. So we can find our x now, né? Using Pythagoras again. We're going to say x squared, okay, plus what? Plus y squared equals to radius squared, okay. So we're going to say, what is our x? Looking for that x, né? What is our y? They gave us what? They gave us root 5, né? So we're going to say root 5. Root 5 squared, okay? Root 5 squared. What about our r? They gave us 3, ne? Equal to 3 squared. All together. So, what's root 5 squared again? You said what? It is 5, ne? So, 9 minus 5, okay? So, what is 9 minus 5? We said we get 4, ne? Then we square root, okay? Square root. So you get our x equals to what? Plus or minus what? Minus 2. So are we going to put positive or negative 2 here on the x? What do you think, guys?
Negative 2.
We're putting negative 2. Is it fine, Mishatama?
Yes,
okay, fine. So now what must we determine? Is it determine what? Determine cos 2a, ne? Determine what? Cos 2a. Any idea, people? How do I find the cos 2a? Any ideas? What must I do? Cos 2a. Cos 2a. What must we do?
We're going to expand using the double angles identities, I think. Yeah.
What do you think, Edibone? What about what do you think?
Yes, we are going to use that.
Yes, we are going to expand, right?
Yes.
No. You see, the given angle is 2A. So we don't expand. We have the 2A, guys. Come on. We have the 2A. Don't you see this is 2A? So just use our diagram the way it is. This is for 2A. It is for 2A. It is for angle 2A. So I'm going to say cos 2A equals to x over radius is simple because the given angle is 2a. Come on, do you see now? Now I know somebody because when they enjoy expanding, they'll just expand directly and then they will miss the target. Okay, so what is our x here? You're gonna say negative 2. What about our radius? It is 3. That's our answer. We are done. Are we together, somebody?
Yes.
What about find time 2a? To find time 2a, what must I do?
-3 over -2.
Negative 2, I mean negative what? It's what, root 5, ne? Again, it's root 5 over what? Over negative 2. Are we together, somebody? Mushatam, I don't want to leave you. Are we together?
We're together.
What about now to find sign A? I don't know what to do. Tell me, please. How do you find sign A? What do you think we're going to do now?
Are we not going to, what do you call, wait, sir.
I'm waiting.
I'm not going to
come again.
Are we not going to divide it by two?
Okay. What do you mean exactly? Can you explain to me, please? Can you just try to divide how?
I see it's an A and you divide it by 2. It says root 5 over 3 divided by 2 on the side.
Okay, please, my people, can you pay attention now? Please don't forget it, man. It will make your life simple. Now, because I'm looking for sign A, and I know sign A can be gotten from sign 2A, so I better say sign 2A. Sine 2a equals to, actually I'm gonna use cos 2a because I don't want to jigger to be simple for me, okay? So I'm gonna say like this now. Come on, I'm gonna say cos 2a, okay? Cos 2a, all together. Because now I'm looking for sine, I'm gonna write it in terms of sine. Anybody who remembers what the answer is? Cos 2a in terms of sine gives us what?
It's
1
A.
It's what? 1?
1 minus 2 sine squared A.
Thank you, my girl. 1 minus 2 sine squared A. I don't know if Kedibon is lost now. Kedibon, are we together?
Yes, but then I was not about to say that.
What did you want to say? Tell me.
I wanted to say the other one that says cos squared A minus sine squared A.
Because, you know, I don't like that. I don't want to do a lot of work. I mean, I'd have to look for cos squared A again. But yeah, I'm going to only have sine, which I want, you know. So, and I know my cos 2A, what is it from our diagram? It is negative 2 over 3. It is just here. How to get a guy? That's our cos 2A. So, I'm going to say here, negative 2 divided by 3. All together equals to 1 minus 2 sine squared what? 2 sine squared A. But my question was asking for only sine A. Did you hear that? So being a negative here is going to become positive. This I'm going to say now 2 sine squared A, 2 sine squared A equals to 1 minus what? 1 plus, actually 1 plus 2 over 3. I don't know if somebody's lost or not yet. Is somebody lost or we are together? We are together. We are together, no? So now, talk to me. What do you get when you add 1 plus 2 over 3? What do you get? When you add 1 plus 2 over 3, what do you get?
5 over 3.
You get 5 over what? Over 3, okay. But because of this 2 which is here, I'm going to divide by 2 both sides. Ne? Is it fine? Divide by what? By 2. Divide by 2, okay. So now I cancel this 2, this one here. I'm left with actually sine squared A. Sine squared A equals to 5 over 6. Is it fine with you people?
Yeah.
Now I do what? I square root. Ne? Because I'm looking for only sine, remember, ne? Looking for what? Only sine A. So I'm going to say sine A equals to root 5 over what? Over 6. That's my answer. Root 5 over what? Over 6, okay? Root 5 over 6. Are we together? That's our answer.
Can you further to can't I expand it any further? Because I tried expanding in, like when I punched it on my calculator, it was 80 over 60.
Now, you know why I must leave it like it is? Because they said, Patrick, don't use a calculator. So they will get you. You see, this girl was cheating. You see, she was punching a calculator. Okay. Are we together now? So better leave it like this to remain safe, ne? Just accept to be that you don't know what to do, and then leave it like that. Okay. Okay. So now I better do something for K here. I see there are many K's here. Which number can I do for you now? Because our time is almost expired. What must I do for you? Question 6, 7, 8, and then choose one question. I did for you here. What do you think?
You can do I think
we better do question 7 or question 6 because it has got many values to do. Né? Which one do you choose? Yes. Do you choose 6 or 7? Choose. Mm-hmm.
Let's just because it consists of a negative angle. Yeah.
We do 6, né? Okay, so can I clean up the board or do you still use the writing?
Clean up.
Okay. Yes, can I call you now? Because I was in the class. Let me call you now. Né? Okay, guys, I'm just a minute, né?
Don't let her know what I think. Do.
Hello,
you open random mute.
Yes, boss.
That can be
Sure. I don't want to realize this technique. I have to be honest here. Before 10 is not possible. It's not possible before 10. The best time I can say it is at 2. 2. Yes. Okay. Thank you, sir. All right. Okay, thank you. Bye-bye. Hello, guys. Can we proceed now?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So now, can I clean up the board? Or are you still writing? I can clean up, right? Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Let me clean up for the first time. Okay, next question is here. You said you're doing question 6, right?
Yes.
Okay, what does it say? Mm-hmm. It says what?
It says if cost 36 equal to K, determine the following in terms of K.
Okay, A, no problem. You can stop there. So they're saying if cost of 36 equals to K, are we together? So we know that our cost of 36. Now, in mathematics, if we talk about equals to K, we don't actually mean K, okay? We mean K over 1. We mean what? K over 1, because if you don't remember, you might get stuck in the exam. Like someone got stuck during the day. Are we together? And don't get stuck. We mean k over 1. Are we together now? So from here, if you look at our set 6, it's less than 90. Né? Less than what? 90. Meaning that it must be in the first quadrant. Né? It must be where? In the first quadrant. So in other words, if I'm going to sketch it, I can say that it will be something like this. Okay, it's going to be here. Are we together? It's going to be here. So this is our 90 here. Okay. So we're going to put our 36 here. Is it fine with you people? 36 there. And then how do we find the cos? We said cos equals to what? Equals to x. Ne? Our x is k. All together. What about our hypotenuse? It is 1. Okay. I'm looking for this y, which I don't know here. But I know that x squared plus y squared equals to what? Equals to r squared. Ne? So what's our r? It's 1. Ne? So we're going to say that our k squared, okay? Our k squared plus y squared equals to what? Equals to 1. Okay, so looking for y, ne? So you're going to say that our y squared equals to 1 minus what? 1 minus k squared, ne? Altogether, what must I do now? Square root. Okay, and then the square root beside also. So, meaning our y equals to root what? Equals to root of 1 minus what? 1 minus k squared, ne? 1 minus k what? K squared. So, we're going to put it here, and you see it is positive, ne? Because it's above what? It's above the x-axis, ne? So, 1 minus k squared. 1 minus k squared, okay? All right, so now, after getting set 6 here, if this is 90, anybody who can tell us, what do you think is this angle here? It's going to be what?
It's going to be
come again.
It's going to be 54.
So this is 54. Okay, Devon, are we together?
Yes.
Okay, so now what must we find? Now read the questions and calculate what? Part SI is what?
Cos negative 36.
Okay, now cos of negative 36. Last time we said that cos of a negative angle is the same as cos of the positive angle because negative 36 is in the fourth quadrant where cos is what? Where cos is going to be now positive cos of 36 because cos is positive in the fourth quadrant. So it is positive cos of 36. I don't know if you're together, somebody.
Yes, sir.
Okay, Devon, are we together? We are together, ne?
Yes.
So,
yes.
What is cos of 36? We know it is k. We are done. Next part, B.
So,
hello.
We don't involve that negative term.
Come again.
We don't involve the negative.
And they gave us, already they gave us, they said the cos 36 is k. So what do you want to do now, Kedivoni? It's here.
Did you say it's negative k?
No, if it was sine, that's where the negative comes in, because sine is negative in the fourth quadrant. But now with cos, you see cos in the fourth is positive, ne? So it's going to be positive cos of 36, that's why it's going to be positive k.
Okay.
Are we together now? Okay, what about part B? It says what? Cos what?
72.
Cos 72. So now, if you look at our given angles, the triangle, which one is near 72? Is it 54 or 36?
It's 54.
I mean, in relation, we can say cos, okay, cos of 2 times 36, because we're talking about 72. Does it make sense to you?
Yeah.
So now this is now a double angle, right? So because I already have the cos here, it's better to put it in terms of cos. And it's going to be 2 cos squared theta. But what is my theta now? It is set 6, right? Cos squared set 6, then minus 1, okay? Are we together? So what is my cos of theta 6? It is k, right? It's going to be 2k squared. 2k squared minus 1. That's my answer. I wish you understand this, people. You get it? What about Mushata? Do you get it?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Next question here. Part C. You need to find sine of 36, ne? Sine of 36. Now, sine of 36, because I have it in my triangle, now this is my angle, ne? If this is 360, what is my opposite? It is root 1 over k, root 1 minus k squared, ne? So that's my answer. It's going to be what? It's going to be square root. Because we said sine is the same as y over r, ne? What is our y here? Root 1 minus what? 1 minus k squared, ne? What about our r? It is 1. Are we together, guys? Hello, talk to me.
Yes, sir.
Next question, part D. It says what? I need to find what now? Sine 72, ne? All together? Sine what? Sine 72. Now, sine 72, in this case, because I've got 36 here, I'm going to use 36 again, ne? I'm going to say, what am I gonna say? What do you think, guys? To get my 72, I can say someone saying, someone saying what? Sine. Someone saying sine of 2 times what? Times 36, ne? All together. So, what do you get when I expand to sine 2 theta? It gives us what? We get 2, we said you get 2 sine theta cos theta, ne? But what is our theta in this case? It is set 6, ne? And then cos what? Cos 36. Cos 36. Okay, so here, what is sine 36? We said it is the same as what from our diagram. What is sine 36? This one, we said it is 1 minus k squared, ne? Under root, right? So I'm gonna say, 1 minus what? 1 minus k squared, ne? Over 1, ne? What about cos of, what is cos of 36? It's going to be what? K over 1, all together. So meaning our answer is going to be 2k, going to be 2k square root 1 minus what? 1 minus k squared. That's our answer, guys. I don't know if we are together. Are we together? So now from there, I can now find out the one which they called 10. So now, what about 10 set 6? Talking about now 10 set 6. That's part in. So 10 set 6, I can get from my diagram again. How do you find 10? 10 is opposite of adjacent, ne? So it's going to be root what? Root of what? 1 minus k squared.
Minus
k squared
over k.
Over k. That's our answer now. Are we together, guys?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, we can stop here. Please try the question 8 and 9, and even the other question 5, which we skipped, ne? We'll mark them on the meet again next time, okay?